Three laps to go this time. Here's Earnhardt.
Boy, now when they got out in that corner, Nemechek's car pushed out. He pushed out in the center of the corner a little bit. But his car is so good right here. He's been able to make up a lot of the difference right here on this track. This is about the closest run Earnhardt's had at him up off of this corner. Nemechek's car hung the back out a little bit off that corner.
It'll be two to go this time.
Dale takes back out and takes a look at that wide line one more time. See Nemechek's car, he has been that. Oh, there we go.
Uh-oh. And off they come off the corner, side by side. And I've got to wonder if Dale didn't lift right there because Joe got himself squared away.
Looked like he got into him and says, man, let's regroup and do this thing over again. But
yep.
They definitely got together getting in that corner. But Nemechek's car hadn't been that high all day. He was out a little bit further than he'd been all day long.
And look at Nemechek.
Right back on the outside.
With the motor.
Good little racer coming right here, I'm telling you.
They're nose to tail, nip and tuck again. Well, in track and field, they call this the bell lap. They ring the bell at one lap to go. And that's the dinner bell. Here they come.
Earnhardt back on the inside. White flag's out. This is the last lap.
That would have been a dead heat.
Would have been a, now, right here before, Nemechek was able to get away from him, pull him down this back straightaway. See if he can do it again.
Back straightaway, Earnhardt pulls away. Nemechek's going to be right with him entering turn three.
It's going to be right to the wire, I'm telling you.
Nemechek up high, Earnhardt down lower. He's been strong, scoots away. Now, does Nemechek have the power, and can he get it down?
Off of this corner is where Nemechek's really made a run. Here he comes to the wire. He's going to beat him to the line.
He's going to win it. Joe Nemechek picks up the victory, win two, and for fourth place behind Todd Bodine, Jeff Gordon holds off Kenny Schrader and Bobby Labonte. Well, not only did Joe Nemechek just win a terrific race, but Neil, I gained a lot of respect for Dale Earnhardt right there. When those two cars got together, Earnhardt probably could have mashed the gas and driven off. He gave Nemechek a chance to get himself squared away. They were side by side down the straightaway and then settled it in the last two laps. That's the mark of a champion right there. We'll be right back.
In America, your car doesn't just get you from here to there. It's a part of your life. To give your car complete protection, Texaco has developed Havoline Formula 3 Motor Oil. With not one, but three kinds of protection against heat stress, starting friction, and engine dirt. Havoline Formula 3. Add more life to your car.
Filtered Miller Genuine Draft. The world's a very cool place.
In trying to make an artistic statement, one should be careful not to let one's personal aroma do the talking. In order not to offend the critics, I recommend RightGuard Sport Stick. It provides maximum protection and the freshest scents, a sublime palette of odoriferous emanations. After all, a true artiste should be remembered for his inspiration, not his perspiration. RightGuard Sport Stick. Anything less would be uncivilized.
When you've got a tough case of athlete's foot, the itching, the cracking, the burning, you want a medicine that acts tough. Tough Actin, Tenactin.
Clinically proven Tenactin cures even the tough cases of athlete's foot fungus. Get Tough Actin, Tenactin.
Banana George Blair does a pretty good job of staying young. We just help him out with the dash, seats, and tires of his car. There is a fountain of youth, and we own the patent, Armor All Protectant.
TNN's exclusive coverage of the Chevy Dealers of New England 250 has been brought to you by Texaco, official sponsor of the 1992 U.S. Olympic team, and by cold-filtered Miller Genuine Draft and Miller Genuine Draft Light, taking the country by storm. Our thanks to Bob and Gary Bear and their families and staffs here at New Hampshire for making us feel welcome. What a last few laps, Neil Pott. There is the man who started this race on pit road, changing spark plugs and ends up in victory lane. Let's have another look there at what happened between he and Dale Earnhardt.
Mike, they're going down in the third turn here. And Nemechek had been down low all day. He got out a little bit further out. Dale comes in and gives him a wrap in the rear. Here we go, rolling back again. Dale comes in. You can see right here, made contact. And at this point, I'm kind of like you, Mike. I believe Dale could have mashed the gas right there and went sailing right on by. It gave him just a little bit of breathing room. And Nemechek showed what a good racer he was. He didn't just give it up. Coming off two, he drove right back by Dale. And then they tried to settle it on the last lap.
They ran each other hard those last two laps. But now Joe Nemechek again finds himself in victory lane. Glenn?
Well, you're looking at one of the happiest people in America right now. What a roller coaster day. Down, up, down, and finally up again. Great job, Joe.
I tell you what, the Texas Pete Lazito Pharmacy Chevrolet, it run good. You know, we started out right off the start. The thing had a miss, and I said, this can't be true. Because the car, you know, we were flying in practice, had our best qualifying run here. And once we got our spark plug fixed, we proceeded to just keep on going. And we got down to the end there. We changed tires. Jeff Burton changed tires a little bit before us, and we stayed out, and we finally got our lap back when Ernie broke and got in the front. And I think the funnest part was those last five or six laps with Dale. They call him the Intimidator, and, you know, we had a good car. I was trying to run my own pace, and he made that last lap charge on me, and they said, don't let him get behind you, get you loose. And then he hits me in the back and turns me sideways. So I turned back up into him to straighten myself out. We bang a few times. Just keep banging. You know, he'd hit me, but I would bang back into him, get straightened out. So it was a pretty good run. The last hit coming off of four, it knocked the toe in out. The thing shook all the way around, and just happened. We got to jump off of him coming off of four. And I tell you what, and, you know, they don't call him the best for nothing. And I'm just glad I beat him.
Well, if there's anybody else in America you'd rather beat in a race like that, can you think of anybody other than Dale Earnhardt?
No, I can't. You know, Dale's been real good to me. He's taught me a lot. And he's helped me, and today he really gave me a lesson on how to win a race, and I wanted it bad, but he wanted it too, but I think we won a little bit worse.
Well, I think you taught everybody else a lesson about not ever giving up. Congratulations again. Now we're going to throw it to Mark Garrow, who is going to award your crew with the Miller Crew of the Race Award.
Yeah, I want to thank Vic Kangas. We had a heck of a race car here today. You know, he put a just a super suspension under us, Garlock, and all the other people.